Hello everybody and welcome back to my Let's Play of the campaign levels of Railroad Tycoon 3 Coast to Coast expansion. So, first of all, it found out something that I probably should have found out earlier, which is that with Fraps, the recording button is F9, and F9 by default in Railroad Tycoon 3 is the button that you press to alternate for a full screen or windowed mode. And obviously you can't have full resolution in windowed mode. So, previously I was recording in 800x600, which obviously did not look very good. Whereas now I'm recording in full screen mode, which actually makes my life a lot easier because it means that I can actually see what I'm doing and the graphics will look better because it'll be in full HD. Or 720p. But anyway, so welcome back to the campaign Let's Play. We are here in the second level. I didn't do the menu screens recording because there's not really a lot to see and it's more inconvenient for me to record. So anyway, this level is called Germantown, USA. All these settlers have brought their dreams of a better life in a free place. However, nothing is free and they'll have to work hard. So will you. These towns are growing fast and they're going to need supplies and transportation if they're going to succeed. You're just the tycoon they're looking for. For a bronze medal, connect St. Louis to Cleveland and have a company book value of 10 million by the end of 1880. So we have 30 years. Silver. So this scenario is actually later than the Go West scenario by about 10 years. And it ends. Well, it starts 10 years later and it ends 14 years later. Because the other one ended in 1866 if you're going for gold. Bronze, rather. Silver. Do exactly the same, but a book value of 25, not 10 million. And earn at least 5 million in industry profit. So, in the last scenario, I bought like a textile mill and some farms. That gave me an industry profit. So, lifetime industry profit of 5 million isn't that much. If you buy a successful industry, you can make about half a million in a year, at least. So 5 million isn't that difficult to do in 30 years. Gold. Connect St. Louis to Cleveland. Have a company book value of at least 40 million. That's quite a lot. Earn at least 10 million from industry profits. That's doable. And you must be the only railroad in business by the end of 1880. Good luck. Yeah, I think I'm going to need it. Special conditions, you may only start one company. So, we can be fired if we do terrible, but unlike the other scenario, we can actually build unconnected track. And also, even though I have to connect St. Louis, which is here, to Cleveland, which is here, so on the map it'd be about here to here, we don't have to start in either one. We can start wherever we want. And we can build unconnected track. So, take a look at all available cargo. There's quite a lot all over the place. In St. Louis, there's meatpacking plant that's profitable. The cows come from here in Springfield. What else is there? There's a warehouse that's profitable. Supplies sugar, which is demanded in the bakery. And in this bakery in Springfield. Cotton, which is demanded by the textile mill. But it demands ammunition. And unfortunately, ammunition is not produced anywhere. So, if I could get ammunition produced somewhere, I could ship it to here and I would make a lot of money in theory. Ammunition is made by iron and later on I think it's steel and I'm not sure actually. It's definitely iron and grain, which is just supplied kind of all over the place. Now there's a lot of grain in here, so I could build I could build a brewery in Springfield. And that would probably be quite profitable. Anyway. What else is there? I normally start in Chicago and connect up to Milwaukee and then Madison. There's a lot in Madison. What's in Madison? Iron. Which is produced all around. So yes, that's going to be very profitable. Which it is. Nothing else though. These goods. There's a lot of tool and dies actually. So I'm not really sure where those. Well, there's a price differential, so those goods would want to go to from Madison to Chicago. Anyway, let's create the company. Now, it turns out that in the earlier scenario, I should have actually been called the New York Central, because the Baltimore and Ohio actually apparently doesn't go to Boston, so, or it doesn't take a line that I took, so apologies. So we'll just become the New York Central again, because I know that this railroad would have been around at this time. And also, it builds around here. It probably connects to St. Louis, it probably connects to Chicago. Actually, it doesn't exist anymore, but it did, so. Before your dreams of starting a railway, out in the Midwest, you've done a little investing. On the eve of your company debut, you hear the investment has paid off. Which one is it? Import the 222 Firefly. Now, the Firefly, I don't know if you've watched my British Isles Let's Play, the Firefly is very fast, but it's unreliable, and to be honest, for the time period that we're doing, we're going to get the American locomotive in 5 years' time, so there's no point. That will quickly become outdated. 10% less for all trains, that would be useful. That'd be very useful, actually. Station building costs minus 10%. That would be useful. But I think that would be more useful. 170,000 investment return. I think that's player cash. Of 170,000 extra, which would mean that I could get more stock at the start, which would be useful for buying out other companies and increasing net worth. So I think I might go with that. Yeah, let's go with that. New York Central to lay track in Midwest. US government has given us a $500,000 grant. Nice. So start with $1.6 million. That's a lot of money. Less than we started in the other one, but we did start with a lot in the other one. So, if I go here to the stock market, we are George F. Train. Now, I'm sorry, but if you're going to own a railway company and the name is Mr. Train, that's a very, very applicable name. I can't think of any other examples where it's like, oh, your company name, or your company is your, like, what your company does is the surname. Like, you don't see a guy called Mr. Supermarket. But you do see a guy called George F. Train. Seen as a wild investor with a Midas touch, during a delay in construction with the Union Pacific, Train built a hotel in Omaha because he didn't like the one that was there. A passionate man, people enjoyed listening to his speeches. So, not a lot to really be said about this man, unfortunately. And we've got four competitors, so that means that in the future, there'll be a total of five railroads, four plus our own. So in the end, we'll have to buy out four different railroads. The AI never seemed to buy out other people's railroads, which is a bit weird. But, because of that 170,000 thing, I've now got a lot of cash, so I can buy more shares of my own company. I won't buy stock on margin at the moment, because it's risky. But I still haven't found. I still haven't decided on where to start. I could start by just buying industry, but that seems a bit boring. Because I'm thinking, if I build a grain, if I build a brewery here, that's probably going to make a lot of money. But on the other hand, coal. There's a lot of coal here. What's this town? But what demands iron? No, it's not enough to be profitable. Logs? There's nothing really here. I could just go with my typical start in Chicago and connect up route. I don't know. Cotton. No. Wool. There's a lot of wool here. This textile mill in Cleveland. Slightly too expensive to buy. And also I'd have to spend all my money on it, which I'm not going to do. Pulpwood. Logs. Pulpwood. No, I won't buy industry. I'm not going to buy industry, but I will possibly... I mean, I will do later, but I'm not going to build one right now. So this port turns alcohol into goods, and alcohol's made in this brewery, but there's no grain. So this brewery's making a loss. Ugh. What's in Toledo? Nothing, really. Any grain for that bakery? Some. In Detroit, there's a tool and die that seems to be profitable. Yes, it's profitable. So I could start in Detroit and connect to Toledo and then maybe Cleveland. That might work. The AI, I think, normally connects up kind of Saginaw, Lansing. They seem to be quite a popular route. This textile mill is profitable. There's no cotton. There's quite a lot of wool. I mean, not huge amount. Nothing seems like a very good idea in terms of where to start. This is quite worrying. I'll have to think about it. Unless I just go with passengers. Because there are quite a lot of passengers on this map. I don't know. I could just go with the Chicago-Milwaukee route, but I feel like there's not anything there. Unless there's just a load of passengers. I'll just do Chicago-Milwaukee. And if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. But I will probably need a large station. Locked. Have the station like that. Perfect. And build along the coast where it's nice and flat. And we want the station to kind of... for Milwaukee. Oops. Flexible. I probably need a large, but I might be able to get away with a medium. No, it looks like I'm going to need a large, unfortunately. And then, what's in Rockford? There's a lot of meat in there's meat in Rockford that we can ship to Chicago. So, but there's also some goods here that we could ship to Chicago. Do we have enough to connect to both? Let's just do Rockford first. Slight hill. Nope. Okay. And a small station in Rockford fortunately manages to fit the entire area. Meat wants to go to Chicago and Milwaukee. Same price difference. Chicago has produce that wants to go to Milwaukee, grain that wants to go to Milwaukee, passengers that want to go to Milwaukee. Yeah. So if we set up a train from Chicago to Milwaukee, we are going to have passengers, but not that many, so I think we can get away with the Baldwin. But I will put a dining cart anyway. And we can haul... Yeah, just put four on with the dining cart. So we've got produce, grain, passengers, and grain. And there's not much left anymore. Where are these... And Milwaukee to... Rockford. And then Rockford to Chicago. So we've got a triangle, sort of. So Rockford to Chicago hauling meat. And then... I think it's Milwaukee to Rockford. We could do... Yeah, Milwaukee to Rockford. Oops. Probably a bad idea, but... Hey-ho. Milk and coal. I'm just scared, because I think that... By the time this train gets to Milwaukee, I don't know if there's any going to be anything left in Milwaukee that's actually going to be haulable back to Chicago. And I've just realised I've not put in maintenance. Or water towers. I always forget. Let's set a dividend. Of... Oh. Even though we have 252,000, they're only letting me raise it up to that amount. I don't know why. Other company. The Saginaw and Lansing, like I said, and then the Holland Eastern. So, I think the Saginaw and Lansing is going to be quite profitable. The Holland Kalamazoo might be, it might not be. It's not a whole lot here. Now, I could do something really sneaky, and when I have the money, I could connect Kalamazoo to Lansing, and then I'd be able to run a train from Kalamazoo to Lansing, and be able to haul stuff away from Kalamazoo into Lansing, or stuff away from Lansing to Kalamazoo. Like, there's some clothes in Lansing that want to go to Kalamazoo, there's some lumber that wants to go here. In fact, how much would that cost? Just to build... quite a lot. About 600,000 in total. Ew. No, I won't be doing that. Probably gonna need to, double track this junction area. There we go. Just this area, because obviously there's gonna be a lot of traffic here as the as the trains go, because obviously we've got Rockford to Chicago, Milwaukee to Rockford, and Milwaukee to Chicago and back. So obviously here is going to get a lot of traffic. But I'm also going to need a maintenance facility in Rockford. And the Holland Eastern... So obviously give it time, but it looks like... Ooh, weapons factory. It looks as though these two won't make money. But these two will. So, if we buy shares in this guy, and let's buy some shares in our own company. Buy shares in these guys. Right. So we've done pretty well this year. Barracks has appeared in Fort Dodge for the first time. That's pretty far away from where we are, unfortunately. And also, there aren't any troops because there's only one barracks. So the troops have to go from A to B, and they will only go from A to B, so you can't haul them from A to C if they don't want to go to C from A. But because there's only one barracks, there are no troops, so that barracks is essentially just creating demand for alcohol, weapons, and ammo. And there isn't any ammo. There's some weapons, or there's a weapons factory here. Iron, of which there isn't any nearby. And lumber, of which there's none nearby, makes weapons. Anyway. The AI are not doing very well. Just increase the dividend by bits. Increase the dividend. Now, there's a lot of traffic on this line. So... I mean, eventually we'll want a bridge out here, but we will want to double track this. So I might just double track it now in preparation. Can't afford to go all the way, and now we can. There we go. Just on the heaviest bits, because obviously we'll have a lot of traffic between, well, just on this line. I must say, that's a pretty, I could have gone straight through, but then I would have had to deal with the hill. So just zigzag snake line. Through the path. We don't have to worry about net worth, but we do have to worry about industry profit, so I might want to buy some industry soon. We'll need a company book value of 40 million later on. This is quite a tough scenario, to be honest. At least I've always found it tough, and I don't know why. I think it's because if the AI do well, and they're not doing well at the moment, so... But 40 million in company book value is a lot, if I'm honest. It's doable, but it is a lot. And buy more shares in our own, that will split. I could short sell, because I will short sell. Because I don't think those guys are just going to surely go down and down and down. I can't see them making any profit. Who are they? The Holland... Annoyingly, the AI don't use custom logos. But when they do use custom logos, it seems like they just get this weird green logo. So I think what's happened here is they're trying to use custom logos, and for whatever reason they can't. So they all just resort to this logo. Which is very annoying, because it means that I can't tell who's who, because they've all got the same logo. But anyway, I just short sold Holland Eastern shares. And yeah, they're not making any money. In fact, no one is. I'm the only profitable company, so buying out the competitors shouldn't be too difficult, assuming I keep making money. Now, let's have a look at industry. Are there any cheap... Are there any grain farms or anything nearby? Well, is this one? Usually, industries are about 10 times more expensive than they're profitable, so if an industry made about 50,000 last year, it'll sell for about 500,000. So this is 450,000, which makes sense. Although occasionally it's... Occasionally that rule doesn't seem to apply. Stock split 2-for-1. Excellent. How are these guys doing? There we go. So their shares are now $14 each. And if I were to buy them out... I could pay... I could buy them out now, to be honest, but... I mean, what have they got? Besides a short line. They've got one bond at 15%. So that's, $75,000 a year. I could technically afford that. But I'm not going to. Not just yet, because there's... I'd be making a massive loss, and I'd have to take out a bond just to buy them out. Now, how are these guys doing? Yeah, they're making a loss. Ooh. That's not good. So apparently, for whatever reason, I had to buy 1,000 shares off these guys. I don't know why, to be honest. Anyway. Boom times ahead. Right, great. Let's take out some loans. 8%? Yeah, let's do that. And Madison to Dubuque. I don't know how you pronounce that. I'm sorry. Oh, there's a lot here. What is it? Oh, there's tool and die. Stealing all the iron and producing a load of goods. So we want to connect up to Madison, if possible. Might have to take out... Not double track. Might have to take out another loan. Or bond. Can we do it? There's a hill in the way. Got slightly wrong. There we go. Slightly flawed, but... I can't afford that one. I can't afford that one. I can't afford any of these, because they're just too profitable. Now, if they build a line from Madison to Rockford, or anywhere, they'll have to pay me money to ride my track. But because it's my track... I can connect from Madison to Chicago. And there's passengers and there's mail that want to go there. Nobody wants to go to Milwaukee wants to go to Madison. So I think I might do Madison to Milwaukee. I think for the sake of speed and fuel economy and everything, and we'll just go with a Baldwin. Does anyone want to go from Milwaukee to Madison? Some people. There's some milk and some... Yeah, so we can do Milwaukee to Madison. So this was a good idea, because we're going to make quite a lot of money from this. And obviously, eventually, we want to connect Chicago to places like, well, there's not anything in South Bend, but Chicago to Kalamazoo, and then Lansing, Detroit, Toledo, and then Cleveland. And then from there, we'll want to go all the way down to Springfield, Peoria. There's not really anything there. Maybe down onto here, Lafayette, Indianapolis, and then St. Louis. Hopefully. I mean, that's the plan. My purchasing power is very low, if I'm honest. So if I buy back some... raise the dividend. Buy back some stock. I can't afford it anymore. Just increase the... It's always very risky, short-selling stock. I find short-selling stock is more risky than buying shares on margin. And to be honest, it reduces their share price, but it doesn't really do anything else. Like, if they're going to go down anyway, then... It does raise your net worth a bit, I think, but maybe it was a bad idea to do that. I don't know, we're doing okay. How are these guys doing? Not good. Buy some shares in our own company on the margin. Change the dividend back up. I think we're doing okay. I mean, it's... We're in an economic boom. If we keep making money... Oops. I need a water tower between here and here. Ah, they keep changing my dividend down. A study has shown that railways could decrease delays at stations by as much as 20% if they had full-time cable operators. The cost to you is 20% more station maintenance. So, that would increase loading and unloading times, or decrease them rather, by 20%. But I have to pay more in maintenance, which isn't actually like the 200,000 building for a large station. It's just... kind of like overhead and maintenance. Do I do it? Yeah, okay. Ah, fuck. Had to buy some shares because of, I don't fully understand that, because, I mean, my purchasing power never went negative. So I'm not sure why I had to buy the shares. Literally no point buying shares in anyone, because everyone's doing terrible, except me. Ha 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 ha. This is being a lot easier than I thought it was going to be. Buy some shares in my own company. Change the dividend back up. And I want to start investing in industry. I can't afford that. Where... Where would be a good place to build an industry? There's a lot of grain here in Indianapolis, so I could build a brewery. But it would require taking out a lot of loans. But I think I might build a brewery in Indianapolis. Or... Problem is, that would help them. But I don't think it would help them enough that it would detriment me. Because these guys are just doing awful. Like, their share price just keeps going down and down and down. These guys are actually making a profit now. But not much. So these guys, Indianapolis and Lafayette, would be the cheapest. But no one's making any money. That's really weird, because normally... Like, these guys would make a lot of money. These guys would make a lot of money. These guys would usually fail. And yeah, these guys would usually fail. But I thought the AI would do better than they are doing, which is quite weird. Can I afford this? I can afford that, and let's buy it. So now we'll make about 40,000 a year in industry profit. Which isn't much, but obviously every little helps. We need 10 million for gold. There is a lot to do. But we are making good money. Milwaukee, Madison. Madison, Milwaukee. Okay. I'm probably going to want to double some of this track up. Investors are excited. We are in an economic boom. There's no point buying shares in any of them because they're just going to go down. At least my net worth is increasing. So, textiles are usually a safe bet. But there's nowhere to build a textile mill that isn't where there isn't one already. Because all the good places already have textile mills. And no. Yeah, this is worrying. What about produce? No. I could build a distillery in Minneapolis, but I still think that... I don't know. A brewery in Indianapolis would be useful. I think that would make a good money. But I can't afford it. How much is it? 2 million. Or 1.4 for the distillery. Huh. What about a paper mill? That requires pulpwood. Economic boom fading, but we're still in prosperity, so that's okay. And obviously, the boom couldn't last forever. Nobody's making money. Excuse me. Except us. Pulpwood. So some pulpwood here. Can I buy that? It's not making any money. Why are these logging camps making no money? I suppose it's because they've got nowhere to sell to. I'm going to buy this coal mine. It's making a bit of money. Every little helps. Ah! Not coal mine here. This grain farm. I kind of want to buy that. Come on, give me money. In fact, 7% loan. No, I'll just wait. Wait for the money to come in, and hopefully it will come in. We're not massively... we're not making a lot of money. Huntington has offered $100,000 to connect to it, but unfortunately it's in the middle of nowhere. We may connect there eventually, but not now. And that grain farm has just disappeared. I can't remember where it was. No. Oh well. There'll be others. Ah! Buy that one. I mean, I could, in theory... You can build an industry wherever you want. You don't have to build it in a town. No, I think we really need to start making some money. Perhaps buy these guys out, the Madison Dubuque. These guys. How much would that cost? Well, if we had 50%, it'd cost 360,000. How much is 50%? Only 10,000 shares. What do they have? They do have a loan. But we would get access to all this. And obviously we have to buy them out eventually for our goal. Let's do it. 6% loan. Buy them out. So there we go, now I have enough to buy them out. Temp merger with Madison Weds. They've gone up. Probably because I bought a load of their shares. Merger succeeds. New York Central takes over Madison Western. So that's because I had more than 50% of their company. I could literally buy them at the share price rather than more. We do have quite a lot. So I could take out another 8% and pay off the 12%. There's not really much point at the moment. Anyway, so we've inherited this station, which has some iron, which wants to go to there. Meat wants to go all over the place. Passengers, nobody wants to... Oh. No, no one really wants to go there. I'm thinking Chicago to Dubuque. We have inherited some trains. Dubuque to Milwaukee. That can stay. Just update it. And then Dubuque to Madison. Yeah, that can stay. And the rest of these were mine. Oh, hang on. Rockford to Chicago. Oh no, that's mine. So yeah, these are all mine. So that is one competitor out the way. There's still three left. So Jay Cook, Daniel Drew, and Charles Crocker. So James Fisk was the... So he doesn't have enough to really start another company. I mean, he could. He could start another company. But if he... Oh, actually. You may only start one company. So, because we don't care about net worth, he's out. Like, he owns some shares, but so what? He can't do anything with them. In fact, how much would it cost to buy out other people? These guys are... These guys are cheap as... So really, the only problem is the Saginaw and Lansing, which is actually making a tiny bit of money. How much... So there's 20,000, so we need another 10,000 in them. And then we took out another loan, and we could buy them out. Or I could possibly connect Kalamazoo to Lansing. No, I think I'm going to buy them out. How much would that cost? 700,000. Let's do it. 9%. Let's do it. Hostile takeover. We have enough, just. Yep, merger succeeds. Oh, we've got a bit of cash left over, that's nice. So we're taking over the Saginaw and Lansing. This may backfire, because I now have a lot of loans. Change the dividend. And my net worth is now huge. These guys, we can worry about those later, because they'll be cheap as anything to take over. Now, Saginaw and Lansing lines. Keep this one, as it is. And we can... We don't really need two trains going from Saginaw to Lansing. Is there anything here? In terms of industry, maybe? That would be nice to buy. That would be nice to buy as well. I could buy that, but I'd need to take out a load of loans. And we can't do that. We're not in... new locomotive, American. So, the American is cheaper to buy, but more expensive to maintain. Less fuel economy. It's faster, worse at hills, but it's faster, more pulling power, less reliable, but passengers like it more. So we might just do a mass upgrade to American locomotives. Maybe. Should start increasing our profits soon. So how much would it cost to connect to Kalamazoo? We can't do it just yet. That would cost, well, 100,000 if we went that way, but there's a hill, so we're not going to. No dividend, because we don't have enough. Can buy more shares in my own company. Let's buy 5,000 shares. Let's buy another. So there we go, 20,000 shares. We're now making negative. We now have negative cash, but we just got a bit of a money, coming in. So we're not doing as well financially, but we did have to buy them out, and we do have more routes available. Eventually, we'll want to connect Kalamazoo to Chicago, and then connect on to Detroit, etc. Actually, it hasn't been that bad a year. So, stock split 2-for-1. Investors are pleased with our performance. So we get 18,000 more. Or 18,000 salary. Company book value, that will need to go up to 40 million by the time we're done. Huh, and we still need a lot of industry. Really need to start buying those industries, probably. Because we need 10 million. Hang on. Is there no way around this hill? I may just have to suck it up. And then just delete this track. Yeah, that's flat enough. Now the problem is if these guys run trains, if they actually have any no, they don't have any money. I was going to say, if these guys build a train, they're going to make money from that, but they're not going to because they don't have any money to buy a train. We can. So we can haul coal from. We can do train from like Kalamazoo to Lansing, and then another train from like Saginaw to Kalamazoo. In fact, Saginaw, Lansing, Kalamazoo, Lansing. So we can't just go like here to here to here to here to here. We do have service tower maintenance, but we'll need another one here. Damn. Come on, money. Money, come in, please. Where's all our money going? Interest. Yeah, because obviously I've got a lot of loans. I mean, we're paying $2.5 million at 8.4%. So we're paying, well, just over $200,000 a year in interest, which is a lot. Anyway, build and maintenance, service. Buying out all these useless companies. They have a lot of. Ah! Distillery has appeared for the first time near South Bend. Where's that? Oh, that's actually really close. Is it going to make any money? Yes, probably. So we will want to buy that. Let's not make any money now. But that's because the sugar and produce hasn't made its way yet. So we could take out $1 million and buy this. 9%. Not just yet. Although it is making a lot of money, so it's kind of like now or never. And it will increase in price. I want to buy this grain farm. How are we actually doing for... Yeah, we really need some industry. I want to pay back these loans, but we don't have enough, and we're not making that much money. How much is the Holland and Kalamazoo? 210, 270. They probably have a load of loans as well. Oh, they've only got one. But 15%, that's a lot. Because that's another 37,500. And I won't be making any money from that line. Ugh. What disaster. I may have actually fucked this up. I don't know. Unless we make a lot of money this year. We're not paying any dividend. No, we're making a lot of money this year. Or now, for whatever reason. The money's coming in. Maybe it's going to be another case of slow start, but eventually we'll become profitable, that we can make a fast... Wow. So there's a lot of iron in Detroit, so we want to connect to Detroit. Large station. Large station for Detroit. Whoops. But we can't actually connect there because we don't have enough. In terms of money. Ugh. Hill. I like how this is a stationary house here. Like. When the money... Just a bit more money. Ah, that's interesting. So the Holland and Kalamazoo people somehow got enough money to start building trains on my track. And last year, or this year rather, we're making an extra 289,000 just from these idiots building trains on my track. Saginaw to Lansing. Oh wait, that's mine. Lansing, Kalamazoo. All entire, basically on my track. So I'm making a lot of money from that. That doesn't look connected, but it is, I think. So, we want a water tower here. And we will need a maintenance, but we can't afford one just yet. Aha! Detroit has goods that we can haul to... I'm thinking... Saginaw to... No. Do Lansing to Detroit with an American. And because it's more powerful, let's just do the full 6 loads. Nice money. Good. So making a lot of money this year. Yeah, the money's starting to pile in, and then eventually we'll want to connect Chicago to Kalamazoo. And probably do Detroit Toledo first. Want to start. How are my industries doing? Oh dear. This coal mine is losing money. It's barely making any money. I could sell it. Let's see how it does this year. Because, might have just been a blip year. So it might do better next year. There are a lot of profitable industries, but they're all too expensive to buy. Which is annoying. Maintenance facility in Detroit. How much would... 8%. No, I think I'll just... Whoa! Making a lot of money hauling goods to Lansing. So if we build a station in Toledo. It would cost another 130,000 to connect. Plus the water tower. So we need about 200,000. Which we're going to get from this guy. Very nice. Very nice indeed. Oh yes. So now we can connect up to Toledo from Detroit. And water tower. And build a train going... Actually, in Toledo there are passengers that want to go... to... Well, everywhere really. No, actually. Let's just do... Short route. Toledo, Detroit. Making nice money. And is there anything in Kalamazoo? Some weapons made in Lansing. Interesting. Because there's no demand for weapons anywhere. Ah! For some reason there's demand for weapons in Chicago. Well, there isn't demand, there's just a price differential. So, if we managed to... If we got... iron... And lumber, which is a lot of... Logs... Iron? These iron mines are probably making quite a bit. Grain? No, I don't know. There's a lot of potential in this map to make money. What's in South Bend? This distillery, which is making good money, which I should have bought when I had the chance. Damn it! Actually, it's not too late. I could just take out a load of loans and buy it. There we go. Bought. And we can upgrade it when we get enough. The problem is now I'm paying... Well, I can still afford the interest, but I'm making a fortune... So because the guy who owns the Indianapolis route is doing so badly, he's been fired. So he can't start another company because of the conditions of the scenario. So, I could just buy a load of shares, but there's really no point. Because I could buy his company for 120,000. What does he actually have? It's got a lot of loans. It's got a fortune in loan. Well, 158,000. Ugh, I don't want that. No, I don't want that at all. Oh dear, this train's broken down. Can't replace the train while it's broken down. Damn it, I thought that'd be some kind of exploit. I thought I could exploit it by, being like, well, it's broken down. If I replace it, that'll fix the broken down. But you can't replace it while it's broken down. Damn. Oh well. It's not that bad. So, we're now beginning to make a lot of money, which is nice. Still need to deliver produce. Nah, we're making good money. Upgrade it in a bit. And we can connect to Cleveland. So Toledo to Cleveland. I don't know what happened there. Slight discontinuity in my rail for some reason. Hey ho. Ah, there's a hill. So I may have to come in from a different angle. I don't want to get these. Ah, here we go. Right. We'll need a large station. Ooh, hang on. I'll need a large station about here. And then I do have a slight hill, unfortunately. I don't need a dividend, really, because I don't have to worry about net worth, and I don't have to worry about buying shares, because they're just... Well, to put it simply as I can, they're shit. Like, they're awful. I mean, that's when we started the game, and they've just gone down and down and down, whereas I've gone up and up and up, except here. And they've gone down, so, no. I'm not going to buy them just yet, but I'm going to buy them when I have to. Anyway, so the wool... Passengers want to go from... No one wants to go to Cleveland. But they want to go to Detroit. And there's clothes that want to go to Detroit. There's meat. I can make a fortune going from Cleveland to Detroit. And we'll create another one going... Blimey. All the meat in Cleveland. And then Detroit back. That is a very nice line. Very nice indeed. Industries. This coal mine is loot. Yeah, sell the coal mine. I mean, it was a bit risky just buying a coal mine in the middle of nowhere. Water here and here. Okay. We still need to connect. Well, we don't have to, but we need to connect here, this line, up to, or down to St. Louis. And I mean, obviously, we ideally connect Kalamazoo to South Bend to Chicago and then down to St. Louis. But we don't have to do that anytime soon. We just have to do it before 1880. Industry profit. So it is making money, and... How's this growing farm doing? Economy's slowing to normal. Not a massive issue. Look at our own... No, I'm not going to buy that. Not just yet. 10%? I'm not going to take out a loan for 10%, not when we have a load of loans already. We'll start paying these back, actually. Pay that one off. Now I can get a loan for 9%, because I think our credit rating just increased. But I'm not going to do that. What I am going to do is build a station in South Bend. connect South Bend to Kalamazoo. There's a slight hill. Nothing serious, I guess. Okay. So South Bend produce. Nowhere really. Saginaw, there's some cattle that wants to go to South Bend for some reason. Lumber, alcohol, obviously. Alcohol wants to go to Detroit and Cleveland. Detroit's closer. Lumber to Cleveland. So South Bend to Cleveland would be very profitable. Let's do Cleveland to South Bend and South Bend to Cleveland. Don't need the dining car, because no one wants to go there, apparently. So, does anyone actually want to go? Toledo people want to go to South Bend, but very minimal. And then obviously, South Bend to Cleveland, making nice money. We will want to upgrade this, actually. Because it's producing 4 per year. And the maximum it can produce is 4 per year, so we want to upgrade it. Which costs 780,000. We are making a lot of money now. 2 million last year. Yeah. We can start buying industry now. Buy this. Just buy farms. Farms are usually profitable. Iron mine. Ooh, that'd be good to buy. Come on. There we go. And this corn farm. Mount Vernon has offered 100,000. We're making it there in the end. At some point, but not anytime soon. How much would it cost to buy these guys? Hang on. Oh no, they're not making any money. But obviously we'll want to buy them eventually, because of our goal. And also because they're kind of in the way. Kind of. Like, they're not fully in the way, but slightly. That's too expensive for what it's worth. Can I upgrade my thing? No, 780. Damn it. Can now. There we go. Boom. Industry profits. We need 10 million, so we will need more industry, and we need a book value of 40 million. That's a fortune. But I think the next step is to connect South Bend to Chicago. We want Stonebridge. Because we'll have a lot of traffic going here, and it's the only way to get double track. 280,000. I think there's a train incoming. Yep. Nice. Go back to wooden bridges. And that'll do. So now I just need to connect. Oh. Money incoming. Hills. Avoid the hills. And there we go. So now we've got Chicago goods. We could do Toledo. Mail wants to go to Detroit. Passengers want to go to Detroit. Iron wants to go to meat. Yeah, Chicago, Detroit would be good. Dining car. And Detroit, Chicago. And let's do a Toledo, Chicago. And eventually we'll want a Chicago, Toledo. Nice. And we don't need that. In fact, we don't need that either. Whoa! Cleveland to South Bend, making a fortune on clothes. Company book value is almost high enough for the bronze. And industries making nice money. This distillery is going to make good money. Train 5 has crashed. Want to upgrade that to a American, and we may as well just put that on full like that. In fact, we don't need that. So, now, how much is a textile mill to buy? And would it make any money if I built one where there's already one set up? Civil War! So we are. 1861. Prices for munitions and weapons up 35%. Now, ammunition is not made anywhere. Weapons, however, are made here in Lansing. And they're demanded in Chicago. Well, there's not demanded in Chicago, but there's a price differential. So Lansing to Chicago. I can probably just set up trains and they'll probably make money. Aha! Hauling some weapons. And some paper, and then Chicago to Lansing. Hauling a load of meat. So yeah, I mean, right now, this line is going to be really profitable. We can just set up trains everywhere and they'll probably make some money. But we will need industries. So, there's a lot of livestock here coming from... But there is a meat plant already. 2.9 million to buy. Damn. Or we could build our own for 2.4, so it's not actually that much cheaper. Ah, great. There's a lot of iron, so we could build our own tool and die. Which would cost 1.6 million. They had the right idea already, so they built... they built the brewery in Lafayette. 4 million. Should have built a brewery there already when I had the chance. Damn. Oh well. Is there anywhere that actually demands munitions? Madison. Ah! So we could build a ammunition plant in Chicago. How much would that cost? 1.8 million. Damn it! Okay, pulp wood. Ah, this paper mill. Could buy it. We need to haul the paper away to Cleveland. So, Lansing to Cleveland, if I haven't done that already. Ideally, haul this paper away. It's hauling a bit. I think I might buy that, actually. How's this brewery doing? Too expensive. Let's buy this. And we could upgrade it. Probably will, to be honest, because it is consistently making 3. How did it make 4.9? That's incredible. That's very weird. So, Lansing is still okay with a medium station. I mean, ideally, I'd build a brewery somewhere, because breweries always seem to make a lot of money. There's a lot of... there's already one there. And he's been fired. So, in terms of buying them out, them being fired doesn't make any real difference. I think I might just buy them out now, to be honest. How much would it... So there's 6,000, 11,000, 30,000, so we need 15,000. And just another. And these guys... In fact, they're so cheap anyway, we can... Buy. Now we have inherited some awful debt. And how are these trains actually doing? What the heck? Oh. Oh, god damn it. Chicago, Detroit, I forgot to build maintenance and water and whatnot. So, water, water, water. Maintenance. Water. Water. I always forget water and maintenance. Anyway. So, on Holland and Kalamazoo line. There's no trains actually here. That's weird. But this train is not profitable. That's weird, but I'm going to keep it anyway. Just modify it slightly. Holland and Chicago. Chicago, Kalamazoo. Keep that. Just modify it. That's one of mine. Upgrade that actually, and modify. Rockford, Chicago. That's one of mine. No. Lansing to Chicago. That's one of theirs that I've inherited. And Lansing to Chicago, we don't need that twice. That'll do for now. Good helping of money. Pay off these awful, awful loans. Can get a loan for 8%. And... I'm not going to buy out these guys anytime soon, simply because A, they're unprofitable massively, B, they're cheap as anything, and we just get a load of loans that we don't want. We still have a lot to do. Distillery, paper mill. No, my industries are doing good. So next stop, I think, will be Mass... Arch... What's in Mount Pleasant? This lumber mill, that's very profitable. So we'll want to connect to Mount Pleasant, probably. I think basically just buy more industry. Buy farms and stuff. Buy farms and just industry. I still think building brewery would be a good idea, but I can't afford. Is there enough grain here? Nah, it's 2 million for a brewery. Which is annoying. My stock will split. I'm not entirely sure how you increase company book value, because it's kind of just a measure of how much your company's worth. But it's different to this, so I don't know entirely how it's worked out. There's no real company book value. This is the value of all assets. This is the value of all assets less any outstanding debt. If you liquidated everything right now at book value and paid off all debts, you'd have this much left over. So it's basically everything that the company owns minus the debt which is 3.5 million. Hmm. So if I add up all this and minus this, does it come to the book value? Well, that plus that plus that. So very roughly, 6 million, 7 million, 10 million, 16 million. Yeah, I think it is. In fact, it is. It's all this minus this. That's interesting. So obviously, buying more industry, and just building more track, and it's kind of a measure of how much the company's worth. So paying off these loans will increase the net worth, or not the net worth, the book value. I think the next step will be to connect down to St. Louis, or St. Louis. Around the farms and around the hills. Connects up to Peoria. There's not really anything here, but we may as well. Increases passengers and... there's some passengers that want to go from here to... we could do here to Chicago. There we go. And up down to Springfield. Oh, we'll need maintenance. Water. Water. Stock will split. Maybe 3-for-1? In fact, I can reduce that now. I don't know why the AI have failed so spectacularly in this game. Or this particular save. Whoops. I mean, normally, at least one of them does okay, but it's been weird that none of them have done okay. And, Springfield. But I'm not complaining because, it makes my life a lot easier. And we're out of money. So I can build a train going from Springfield to Chicago. Are there any passengers? No, not really. Well, yeah. 2-for-1. So I'm not bothered about net worth, but it's always nice to have a net worth that's high. Look at all these failures. Well, actually, he's doing okay. He's got no money. Oil well. Let's buy it. Why not? Now, it's a shame that nothing demands... it's a shame there's no industry that demands corn. Buy that. Because there's a lot of corn around. Buy that. How are the industries doing? This oil well's... we're making a slight loss at the moment. Paper mill, doing good. Distillery, doing good. We're doing pretty good at the moment. Slow start, but... if we connect to St. Louis, we've got the gold... I mean, bronze. Silver, we need 5 million and 25 million. So we can do that. I think. We should be able to do that. Gold. 10 million and 40 million. Gold's going to be very difficult. Simply because of like the book value and the industry profit. I want a stone bridge. That's going to cost about 500,000. There's a lot of money to be made in this map. Especially in the north, like in Michigan kind of area. Michigan, Ohio. Like Toledo, Detroit, Saginaw, Lansing. That's why I thought the Saginaw Lansing line would be better than it did. It's weird, I don't know why. They didn't do anything. Anyway. Bloody hell, there's a lot of wool in here. Where's it coming from? Coming up the river from these sheep farms. We could build a build a lumber mill. Because there's a lot of logs. Could build a distillery. A lot of potential. Wow. 5.5 million to buy that brewery. It's making a fortune. It's still not actually producing to full capacity. Need the money to come in. Where's the line? There it is. So, there we go. St. Louis, or St. Louis and Cleveland come together. New York Central delivers the goods, and then some. So, water, there's already a station in Springfield. Water, and maintenance in Springfield. So, Springfield to... No. Springfield to Chicago. Or Springfield to... Not Springfield. St. Louis to Chicago. With a dining car. Chicago to St. Louis. No dining car. So put a dining car there. No dining car there. Like that. I don't think we've got Chicago to Cleveland. And then Cleveland to Chicago. And just... I don't think I did... No, I don't do Springfield to St. Louis. There we go. And there's a lot of potential in St. Louis to build some industry, because there's just a lot here. This warehouse produces... So because of this constant supply of sugar and cotton, we could build a textile mill and a distillery, and it'd probably do really well. So 1.4 million, and we can build this distillery. Which turns the sugar... Very pleased with our performance. Why would they not be? Frankly, we're amazing. So, distillery, and a textile mill, and I could build a steel mill, maybe. Is there enough? No, there's not enough. Not really enough iron. But, distillery. Come on, 1.4 million. There we go. So that converts the sugar and the produce. There isn't actually that much produce. But it converts the sugar, which is produced at the warehouse. Munitions factory in Memphis? Ah. So it's iron and steel. So if I had a load of iron somewhere, oh, I don't know, Toledo has iron, we could build a munitions factory. And then we haul ammunition over to maybe South Bend. Oh, this distillery is making lots of money. How's the other distillery doing? Oh, this oil well is not making any money. Sell the oil well. No, wrong one. This one. So it's already starting to make money. Could upgrade it later on. But no, I want to build a textile mill. because there's a huge amount of wool for whatever reason. So this textile mill will make money. It will have to compete with this one, which is too profitable to buy, unfortunately. And they're only somewhat pleased with us. We had a good year last year, that's weird. It's not weird that we had a good year, it's weird that they cut salary despite having a good year. Boom times ahead. We still have 3.5 million in... Yeah, pay some of this off. That will increase the company book value. Well, no, it doesn't, actually, because we're paying cash, so it actually decreases it, but it means... Aha! Steel mill in Toledo. That will make a lot of money, so we want to buy... 1.9 million, damn it. Increase that to a large station. But I will want to buy that, because... Union wins. Who'd have thought that? Weapon prices down 35%. Not a big issue because I didn't make that much money hauling them anyway. But I want to buy that. Aha, the consolidation. Now the consolidation is more expensive to buy and more expensive to maintain. It's more reliable. And it's better fuel economy. And it's much faster and it's better on hills. So it's all around better than stuff. Why is the coal and the iron not going to this steel mill? Civil War is over. Reduce the cost of track laying by 20%. Track maintenance will... I've already built all the track... I've already built a lot of track. So no. No. Because I've already built a lot of track. Ah, now it's starting to actually get the, Ah, jeez. 25 million, 5 million. So we've almost got silver. But I did think silver would be quite easy. And we could buy this. Hopefully it'll make money, because we did just spend all our money on it. But hopefully it'll make money. No, it's making good money now. Now it's actually, where's this coal? Okay, there's coal mines nearby, and there's iron mines nearby that we may want to buy, actually. So buy these. Buy this farm. Very pleased with our performance. We are in an economic boon, so it's easier to make money. But we made 4 million last year. Wow. Bit more book value, and we've got the silver. Because we made enough industry profit. We might actually get gold, to be fair. 1.56 million to... Ah. No need to upgrade just yet. How are we doing for traffic? This textile mill. Textile mill's barely profitable. These textile mills aren't doing very well. Meatpacking plant. Now I've had... I'm gonna buy this. Maybe. It's 3.3 million. I've got to build my own. Actually, how are these industries doing? I'm going to want to upgrade that. And I'm going to want to upgrade that. And how's this one doing? I could buy that as well. For 4.8 million. Okay, we've got the silver. So now we just need a bit more industry profit and a bit more company book value. I think we're going to get the gold. I think we've basically done it, to be honest. 8.3 million for that one. Whew. Can I build a furniture factory? No. Stock split again. I don't care. Really. Because my net worth is stupidly high. I could actually... I could buy the rest of these shares. And now I don't have to worry about the investors because I own all the shares. I just hope I don't get a margin call. You have complete ownership. Haha! I can't be fired. I own all the shares. I don't have to worry about the investors. I mean, not that I was going to be fired anyway, but I own all the shares. And that's just... I mean, this share price will go down massively, but my net worth has just exploded. Not that I care. But I mean, if I did care about net worth, then my net worth has just exploded because I own all the shares in my company. Just as long as the purchasing power remains positive. Huh. We've almost made enough industry profit, so... let's buy this. Let's connect up to... Or down... Down? Yeah, down to Fort Wayne. Yeah, this scenario's been a... This scenario's been a lot easier than I thought it was going to be honest. And I'm very happy for it, because the AI were terrible. Oh, there's some troops that want to go to... Troops that want to go to Chicago? Why do they want to go to Chicago? There's literally no reason they want to go to Chicago. Weapons. Can I haul weapons? Now if we had some... Oh, hello. This is making a fortune. Iron and lumber. How's my steel mill doing? Ah, you beauty. Making a lot of money. So I was very fortunate that that was built. And then I spotted it. Because I'm going to want to upgrade that. Jefferson City, 100,000. We could do that. Maybe. There's not really much point. Come on, bit more money, bit more money. If you supply them with the material, steel mills make a fortune in this game. Because they can because they can make so much stuff. They're just gonna... for whatever reason, they're just gonna keep increasing my salary, so... Or, hopefully. All we have to do now is buy these guys out, which is easy. And we've got 12 years to... increases book value by 7 million, or just slightly over. So that's rapidly decreased, but oh well. I could just buy a load of shares of these guys. Not really much point. I might have to set a dividend. Just to make sure that purchasing power doesn't actually go negative. It shouldn't do, but you can never be too careful. I can basically just sit back and we've got gold. Because obviously the... the company book value does depend on the cash. But we're making... We only need 3.5 million and we're making that easily, so... I've got gold. Just need to buy out these guys. And I think... Actually... steel bridge has become available. Let's build a steel bridge. Maybe that... I think that became available in 1865, I just didn't pay attention. Oh dear. I could actually do a mass upgrade to consolidations, but I can't afford it, and there's not really much point. But what I will do is upgrade anything older than 10 years to a consolidation. Is there actually any advantage? Other than it being cheaper? No. Okay. And just out of interest, are all those trains Baldwins? No. So it cost me... All locomotives greater than 10 years old. Let's just do that. There we go. So now we have some consolidations. And... maintenance... Water... 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 Anything in Fort Wayne? Some troops. A load of weapons that want to go to Chicago. So Fort Wayne to Chicago. Fortune. And to do Chicago, Fort Wayne. Barely anything. In fact, you know what? Actually, yeah, let's keep it like that. I think buy them out now. Oh. Damn it! I forgot to buy the shares. I'll have to wait until next year. Not that it's a problem, but... So the company book value, which I reckon that by 1870 we'll have won with gold. Madison Zephyr, nice. Don't care. It's middle of nowhere. It's nowhere nearby. So Lafayette can't upgrade their station, obviously. Chicago. Yeah. Chicago to Lafayette, or Lafayette to Chicago. With the dining car. And vice versa. Well, this has been easy. Far easier than I thought it was going to be. So... Yeah, this has been, it's been nice. Salary hasn't increased. Not complaining. I'm really happy with how this has turned out, but I feel... The AI being so terrible has obviously made it a lot easier. Just upgrade that to a consolidation. Why not? Very heavy in Chicago, obviously. So I'm going to want to double track this. Heavy at the junction. This way. Just double track all here. Why not? I can afford it. It's not like I'm going to have to buy anything soon. Kalamazoo. Yeah, let's give you a large station. Oh, there's a steel mill. But it's not making any money. Holland. Large station. There's a whole load of passengers. There's loads of passengers everywhere. Why are there a load of passengers everywhere? And especially Holland. Like... This is very weird. Holland to Chicago. I don't need trains anymore, really. I mean... We've got gold already, so... This is just... Unnecessary, really, but... Hey-ho. Can I do the merger, or do I still have to wait? I still have to wait. Damn. Oh, well. How are these industries doing? Very nice. Very nice. Very nice. Anything actually... Wow. See, this is what I mean. If you have a steel mill and you provide it with the goods, it makes a fortune. Because there's just a ton of steel in Toledo. Economic boom fading. That wants to go to Detroit for this tool and die, which is making a fortune because of all the iron and steel. Wow. Anyway. Buy out these guys. Buy them out. And that is gold. Hopefully. Should be gold. Maybe we've got to wait until the end of the year. A golden victory! No task undone, nor challenge unmet. Congratulations. Yes. So. That was, Germantown, USA. I will save the game as Germantown. Save. So, thank you so much for watching. That was Germantown, USA on hard with gold medal. Thank you so much for watching. Like, comment, share, subscribe, leave a question and comment below, and I'll see you in the next video, and bye-bye.